Hello, everyone. Welcome to Health Professional Radio. I'm your host for today, Tabetha Moreto. Our guest today is Michelle Miller, the CEO and Managing Director of Biotron. Dr. Miller has worked for over 20 years in the bioscience industry. Today, we're going to talk about a very interesting topic. Biotron's drugs target virus proteins, which is able to treat diseases such as hepatitis C, HIV-1, dengue, Zika virus, etc. Without further ado, welcome to the show, Michelle. I'm so happy you can join us today.
Thank you very much. I'm really delighted to talk to you and to tell your listeners about the exciting work that our company is doing.
Yes. Speaking of your company, please tell our audience more information about yourself and your company, please.
Okay. So my name is Michelle, as you know, and I've been working in the area of HIV in particular for most of my career, and have a background in PhD in that, but I've also worked in the finance industry for a number of years before coming into a biotech company 16 years ago. So Biotron is an Australian biotechnology company. We came out from the Australian National University in Canberra with some ideas of how to treat viruses in a different way, how to attack it in ways that other drugs don't attack, and it means that you can target them in a different way to prevent resistance and come up with ways you can treat diseases that we've not been able to before. So Biotron is primarily focused on HIV as its main target, although we also have clinical programs for hepatitis C and other early stage programs against some other viruses. But really, I think what's the most important one to discuss right now, the one that we're most excited about, is our HIV program.
Sounds very fascinating. Now, tell us more about this drug that your company has developed.
Yeah, so our drug has a very exciting name, which is BIT225. And the reason it's 225 is it was the 225th compound that we made. We came up with, you know, the idea of how to target HIV in a different way. This came out from very exciting research from our founder's laboratory at the John Curtin School back in the late 1990s. So, you know, things take a long time to develop, and we have been designing drugs which would attack the virus in particular reservoir cells for HIV, and then take that drug that we designed through various preliminary testing before you can put it in humans, and then taking it through clinical trials to the stage where we are now in the just about to complete a phase two clinical trial. So I guess just to give people maybe some background about, you know, the indication and about why HIV matters is, you know, the reality is that HIV is no longer a public health issue. HIV/AIDS rather is no longer a public health issue. And so while AIDS is no longer an issue, HIV still continues. In Australia, each year there's about 1,000 new cases. And there's a bit of complacency, I think, in particular in young people who probably don't remember the dreadful problems, you know, with HIV and AIDS in the sort of 1980s and early 1990s. Just more complacent these days, and the numbers in young people are a concern. I guess also the other problem is that, you know, certainly in 2015, a quarter of the new HIV cases in Australia were people who'd been infected for, you know, more than 4 years. So there's still some way to go in terms of making sure people don't become infected. The other reason why we're interested in HIV is because the reason why we are so interested in HIV is because of the possibility of eradicating this virus. It used to be thought that you can keep patients, you know, long-term on existing antiretroviral drugs, which work very well at keeping the T cell part of the disease in check. We can now keep patients, you know, alive really for the term of their natural life with the current existing drugs. But the reality is that the virus is still present in those patients. you take a patient who's in long-term infected but been on drugs, the virus is below the level of detection, and yet as soon as you stopped giving drugs to those patients, the virus rebounds. So the virus is always there in those patients. And the reason why that is a problem is you're starting to get, it causes diseases and problems in patients, having that virus always there at low levels, kicking along. We get issues with AIDS-related dementia, now known more commonly as HAND, or HIV-associated neurocognitive dysfunction. There's issues with immune aging and senescence. There's also now problems with, drug-drug interactions, aging population, people needing to take other drugs, having to take this quite a cocktail of antiretroviral drugs can limit the prospects of treatment for other diseases they may get as they get older due to interactions with other drugs. And, of course, the cost. We don't say this for any other disease as well, we'll keep you on drugs forever. The reality is, let's try to eradicate the virus. And that's really the space that Biotron is working in with its drug.
This is very fascinating information. Now, can you tell us, why is this particular topic relevant, especially to health professionals?
The reason why this is most relevant to healthcare professionals is we're coming up with ways to eradicate a problem in population that is now aging. Patients who are long-term infected on these drugs can have issues with age-related dementia, with their immune aging, with the issues with the interactions with other drugs. So if there was a way to actually get rid of the underlying virus, then you can improve the health outcome in those patients, and their immune and virus status going forward means that the issues associated with that won't be there anymore. And in addition, there will be, of course, the cost benefit from being able to either stop or at least reduce these expensive treatments.
That's interesting. Now, tell me, what is the biggest misconception about the drug that you have developed that drives you crazy and it keeps you up at night?
Look, I think, there's a couple of things, but one of the key ones is people often say, well, isn't HIV, the problem's over, isn't this fixed? The reality is that it's not. We still, as I said, have people, 1,000 new infections every year in Australia, worldwide, over 2 million new infections every year. So the fact that it hasn't gone away, the problem is still there. AIDS is no longer a problem because we can treat patients, but the virus is still there. It is still being transmitted. The other thing that really drives me crazy is the misconception about translational research and how long that can take. We see breakthroughs published or reported in the newspapers and on TV regularly, that some researcher at a university has come up with a groundbreaking discovery. And people then expect, great, this is going to be available to them next year. The reality is, a scientist at a university coming up with an idea, it then takes over a decade or 15 years or more to take that concept from that early idea to designing a drug, to taking it through early stage testing, to performing clinical trials, and it costs a lot of money through that process. And it's not sexy, it's not interesting to people, it's not breakthrough all the time, it's solid work that takes it through from a discovery, exciting in the newspaper phase, through to having a product that can be sold and benefit patients. And I think a lack of understanding of that process is really one of the things that I would like to change.
Thank you very much for clearing up those misconceptions today. I agree with you that HIV and AIDS is something that a lot of people are afraid of, especially you mentioned back in the 1980s and 90s, this was something that was really feared. But luckily nowadays, because as technology advanced, as time went on, now people understand that HIV may still be there, but maybe sooner or later there'll be a treatment or a cure for it.
Well, that's what we'd hope. It certainly is no longer a death sentence, and I think it's a really fantastic work that scientists and doctors around the world have achieved to get to this point. So let's try to get to the next stage where we can actually eradicate it for good.
Excellent. So now, Michelle, can you tell us, how can people get in touch with you?
So the best way to get in touch with us is via email, and our email is inquiries, E-N-Q-U-I-R-I-E-S, at biotron.com.au, and also on our website, which is biotron.com.au.
Thank you very much, Michelle. Now, before we end the program, what is your main takeaway message to all of our audience out there?
I think my main takeaway message will be that viruses are part of our lives. We need new drugs which will help prevent some of these, you know, the outbreaks. For example, you know, with influenza, with Zika, we've seen SARS outbreaks in the past. These viruses aren't going away. We need to come up with great ways to be able to eradicate them before they get us.
Very well said, Michelle. Thank you so much for your message. I really appreciate you coming on the show today.
Thank you very much.
And that was Dr. Michelle Miller, CEO and Managing Director of Biotron. We've just been talking about Biotron's drugs target virus proteins that can help treat viral diseases such as HIV. If you like this interview, transcripts and archives are available at www.hpr.fm. We're on all social media platforms, so don't forget to follow, like, and subscribe. We're also available for download on SoundCloud and iTunes. I'm Tabetha Moreto, and you're listening to Health Professional Radio.